What's the next question today?
Ooh, I like this next question. Benjamin C. says, like you, I'm very pumped to see the new Dune movie by Denis Villeneuve, and I've loved all of the casting so far. But today might be the best casting news yet.
Woo!
Stellan Skarsgard is going to be playing the evil Baron Harkonnen, and I can't believe how great this is. What are your thoughts on Skarsgard joining the cast, and do you think this means good things for Dune? What do you think? I mean,
look, Stellan Skarsgard is just one of those actors in this business. He's kind of like, look, I'm not saying he is Anthony Hopkins. I'm just saying he is, to me, the name Stellan Skarsgard is likened unto an Anthony Hopkins or a Patrick Stewart. The type of name that you just kind of bend a knee a little bit when you mention him. I think this guy, who is not in all the greatest movies in the world, he's been in some great ones, but his career has not been peppered by being in the greatest of movies. But he is always one of the greatest performers. This guy can do an MCU movie in Thor and then go off to an edgy little film like Nymphomaniac. And he can do them both, and he can do them both with excellence. Oh my God, as the bad guy in the North American version of The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, I thought he was spectacular. I loved him in the Mamma Mia films. I loved him in everything.
I loved him in Hunt for Red October.
Yeah, absolutely loved him in Hunt for Red October. And on top of all that, the guy just, he has talent in his genes because yay unto his seed. He's got like three of his kids are like turning out to be really great actors. At this, all the Skarsgards, the kids, right? And none of them are as good as their dad.
No.
But I'll tell you what, as Baron Harkonnen, I read that and my face just lit up. I'm like, damn right, Stellan Skarsgard is Baron Harkonnen. Well, what did you think about
this? You know,
this?
It's funny because Dune came out, David Lynch's Dune came out in 84. And Kenneth McMillan played famously Baron Harkonnen, or as they would call him in the movie, the flying fat man.
Yes.
That's a line from Dune. And he's the David Lynch version of that character with the boils on his face
and
pulling out the heart plugs. This is going to be a very different movie. Denis Villeneuve has proven throughout all of his movies are, they can be dark, they're very elegant. Arrival is one of my favorite science fiction films I've seen in a long time. Dune is one of my favorite books of all time. And I think that he's going to bring an elegance. He'll class up that joint. He's going to make Dune, I think Dune, his version of Dune, could be one of the great science fiction films of all time. I think Blade Runner 2049 is
no
amazing,
pressure, no big expectations.
I know. I'm setting myself up, but I do think that I don't think that there's been a director paired with material I've been more excited about in a very long time.
Yeah, Denis Villeneuve doing a Dune is kind of a dream.
The casting: Timothy Chalamet as Paul Atreides,
yes.
Rebecca Ferguson as Lady Jessica, yeah. and Stellan Skarsgard as the Baron Harkonnen. Who's
Dave Bautista as his nephew.
Dave Bautista as the Beast Raban. Yeah. I mean, who are they going to get to play the Padishah Emperor? And who are they going to get to play Gurney Howe?
Who's going to play Leto?
Yeah.
Like who's going to play Paul's dad? That is the casting that I am next holding my breath for.
Right.
Who's going to play Timothy Chalamet's dad? Because you had, on the television miniseries part of it, they had William Hurt.
Right, and he was great.
He was wonderful in that role. So I am dying to see that's the one I'm waiting for now. I'm just dying to see who they put in that spot.
I just want them to go all Ben-Hur and Ten Commandments and make this movie 4 hours long.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
I want.
You
that's
know
what
that,
I want.
That is not going to happen. Don't hold your breath, my friend.